जाननम भूतगणाति सेवितम कपित्त जंबू फल सार भक्षितम उमातुतम शोक विनाश कारणम नमामि विघ्नेश्वर पाद पंकजम आपदाम पहर्तारं दातारं सर्व संपदां लोकाभिरामं श्रीरामं भूयो नमामि अहम् अर्थानाम अतिहंतारं भीतानां भयनाशनं दुष्यतां कालदंडं तं रामचंद्रं नमामि अहम् रामाय रामभद्राय रामचंद्राय वेदसे रघुनाथाय नाथाय सीतायाः पतये नमः कूजन्तं राम रामेति मधुरं मधुराक्षरम् आरुह्य कविता शाखां वन्दे वाल्मीकिकोकिलं वाल्मीके मुनिसिंहस्य कवितावनचारिणः शृण्वन् रामकथानादं कोनयाति परां गतिं कोष्पदीकृतपाटीशं मटकीकृतराक्षसम् रामायण महामाला रत्नं वन्दे नीलात्मजम् अञ्जनानन्दनं वीरं जानकीशोकनाशनं कपीशमक्षन्तारं वन्दे लङ्काभयङ्करम् We were with Sita, the auspicious woman, the auspiciousness of God, whatever you say, in her heart made her eyes flutter. Her left arm, which was plump, it was round, left arm of hers, Valmiki says, handsome in its rounded plumpness, which was worthy of Chandana, Agaru, etc. It was worthy of the best of such anjuvans. What is the fame of that arm? On that arm, Sri Rama has kept his head and slept. That arm shook, throbbed.
Gajendrahastaprathimascha peenattayordayoh sammhatayoh sujatah praspandamanah punururvasya ramam purasthasthitamacha chakshe. The legs are, in Sanskrit alliteration, this thing, analogy is usually compared to the trunk of an elephant. So her legs, which were close to each other, her left thigh, that throbbed, and it seemed to be telling her, Rama's purastat, that Rama is nearby. शुभं पुनर्हेम समानवर्णं ईषद्रजोध्वस्तमिवामलाक्ष्या वासस्थिताय शिखराग्रदन्त्या किञ्चित् परिश्रंसद चारुगात्र्या. The beautiful Sita, who had bright eyes and had teeth which were like pomegranate seeds, this is a very interesting woman, timeless kind of woman. So her dress, she had no change of dress. She had been wearing the same thing here now. Golden colored dress. It's not that she couldn't even wash it or something. So it has become soiled. But such is her adeptness or whatever you call it, that it doesn't look too much soiled, it looks slightly soiled. She's keeping that all right. But it's slightly soiled and months of not having changed. That dress, which is still looking so nice, that, what happens, suddenly it becomes slightly loose and slips down a bit. that knot or whatever which is she ties tightly, it slightly slips down, loosens and it slips down a bit. The dress that she is wearing suddenly becomes a bit loose. Like she's lost some weight, a bit of weight, or some fat has gone off, or whatever. Apparently she is very happy. It's a very good omen. Shubham punarhema samanavarnam ishatratu dvastarunamalakshyamasa sthitaya shikaragradantya kinchit parisram sadajarugatriya. Little bit it slipped up. This was another omen that she saw. एतये निमित्तैरपरै च शुभ्रू सम्बोधिता प्रागपि साधु सिद्धैः वातादपक्लादमिव प्रणष्टं वर्षेण बीजं प्रति सञ्जर्ष. लैक् वित् दीस् अदर् सैन्स् रियश्योर्ड् हर् लैक् अ रियश्योरिङ्ग् ओमन्स् फोर् हर् बिकास् आफ् दीस् ओमन्स् शी हेड् पर्सनल् नालेज् इट् इस् नाट् दट् She has just, not that she has been trained since if this comes means this means something. It's not just book knowledge. Experiential knowledge of these omens and what they mean. So she was happy, a sudden burst of happiness, and she was recovered her spirits and all that. And she suddenly rejoiced like what? Like a seed. There's a seed which has been sown in the field, but there has been summer. And there's drought, there's nothing, the whole earth has cracked. And then there is some rain. And in the rain, that seed sprouts. Like that. With these, because of these omens of which she had personal knowledge, she felt a new surge of life flowing into her. Now, Valmiki doesn't give an idea here what was that personal experience, etc. How did she know? But it is left. Antarama teacher says, I think maybe from some other classics of Ramayana, that when that phenomenon was going on, and king after king came and nobody could even lift that thing. It became a case of, this two girl will not get married also. So for Janaka, he was a bit depressed. Yeah, this is too much. I mean, yes, not one fellow is being able to meet this challenge, but this is a challenge that his destiny has given her, this girl. She has come, been born with this thing next to her. Which of course in another classic, it says, in Adbhut Ramayana, it says as a small baby she used to just move, push it here and there. But no king, including Ravana, could not lift. So this was the scene, and even she was now very down. Shadi Yoga, she is not very young girl, looking forward to a princess. Now, bloody king is worth it. At that time, suddenly her left eye had started fluttering, her left hand had started fluttering, her left leg had started fluttering. Her dress had become a bit loose and all that. And she looked out and she saw down the highway, there was a rishi coming along with him, Ram, the prince. So she had seen him at that time first. And she had been filled with unknown reason, filled with happiness at the sight of this handsome young prince who was walking. So that same omens came here, which indicated that Rama is coming. This is what they say, as what she had personal knowledge of these omens before. So she was feeling good, nice. Tasya punarbimba phaladarushtam Like the moon, which is delivered from the Rahu Mukham, from the mouth of Rahu, the eclipse mouth, Her face started shining. She of the lips like the bimba fruit, lovely eyes and eyebrows. Her fair and lovely curls, curled eyelashes, all that he says in his verse, gleaming white teeth. She, her face started shining like the moon which has been released from by Rahu. Savita Shoka, her sorrow had left her. Vyapanita Tandri, the entire fatigue of body vanished. Shantajwara, the fever that she was having, left. Harsha Vibuddha Sattva, her strength was renewed by joy. Ashobhatarya Vadanena Shukle Shetam Sunaratri Vibodhitena. She was like a night of the bright fortnight with the moon rising. After the Amavasya is over and the moon is rising, the bright fortnight starts. How does the night feel? She felt like that. That's the 8 verses of Shubhanimitta. So now, all this is happening. Hanuman, he doesn't know that what these omens he has seen, etc. He is sitting in the tree. As far as he is concerned, she is ready to commit suicide. He also heard Trijata Swapna. She also said the monkey messenger of has come, he'll set fire to Lanka. All that is heard. It's been an eventful night for him. He said, Ravana, come and go. The Rakshasi is torturing her, harassing her. All that he has seen. And he was looking at her, and she was looking like a goddess in Nandavana. And when he looked at her from the tree, from his perch, many thoughts crossed his mind. Valmiki says, I have found her. She who has been sought by countless apes in every direction on the earth, that lady I have found. And I have seen everything in this place, Lanka, that an evil spy who is going around without being seen, unknown to anybody, an evil spy, assessing the enemy's strength. Whatever he should do, I have done. I have seen Rakshasas of every kind, every degree, high Rakshasas, low Rakshasas. I have seen the city, I have seen the might of the monarch of Rakshasas, Ravana. Now I am seeing this lady who is crushed by grief and by her separation from her husband Rama, who is incomparable and whose compassion embraces all creatures. She is crushed by her separation from him, and I must do something to console her.